closet door.
I'm here in my studio, aka board game closet. I love this song. I'm worried we use it too much, but it's still a good song. Anyways, before diving into today's nugget of civics, I wanted to thank those of you who have donated to keep this bird in the air. We simply can't make the show without that tried and true public radio standby, listener donations. If you listen to the show and can support it, just go to civics101podcast.org and click donate, or just click the link in our show notes to give a gift in any amount. $5 a month as a sustaining member, it gets you a swanky new Civics 101 face mask. But whatever amount you can give, please know we are going to keep asking people smarter than us to answer your questions about how our country works. Thank you. Thank you. All right, here's the show.
Civics 101 is supported in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.
His final pardoning of the turkey as commander-in-chief.
Well, this turkey must have said some prayers of his own, and we're going to grant him a special presidential pardon.
During a president's lame duck phase, the 70-ish days before a new president takes office, an interesting thing happens. Many departing presidents go on a pardoning spree.
President Trump wiping out the conviction of his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn, who had pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI in the Russia investigation.
This is Civics 101. I'm Jackie Fulton.
And I'm Todd Bellamy Walker, a fellow here at Civics 101.
Today we're answering a question from Robert. Why do outgoing presidents pardon so many people?
I hereby pardon you.
What is a presidential pardon?
Article 2 of the Constitution gives the president the power to grant reprieves and pardons for federal crimes.
It's a get-out-of-jail-free card, but not just jail. When pardoned, a person is no longer required to pay fines, follow terms of parole, or discuss the conviction on job applications. The president can pardon pretty much anyone who has committed a crime.
Now, therefore, I, Gerald R. Ford, President of the United States, have granted a full, free, and absolute pardon unto Richard Nixon for all offenses against the United States.
Article 2, Section 2 of the Constitution says that president shall have power to grant reprieves and pardons for offenses against the United States, except in cases of impeachment. So that's a pretty broad power.
That's Andrew Rudalevige, professor of government at Bowdoin College. We talked to him in 2017 for a civics episode about presidential pardons.
Andrew says there are two exceptions.
One is that it has to be a crime against the United States, so a state crime wouldn't count. And secondly, the pardon power can't be used as a way of avoiding impeachment.
Think less murder, more white-collar crime.
It's purely discretionary, even if the president's staff doesn't agree with it. President Jimmy Carter, for example, granted a blanket pardon to draft dodgers.
To all those who had defected from a military in order to avoid service in Vietnam. I didn't pardon deserters.
Requests for pardons go through the Office of the Pardon Attorney.
There is a set of regulations that are designed to systematize this process. I mean, presidents get many thousands of requests for pardons or commutations of sentences every year. And so most of the people that the president pardons, he doesn't know who they are.
That brings us back to the 11th hour pardons.
President Obama will leave office Friday with the most commutations in White House history. He pardoned 64 people yesterday.
Why the sudden flurry of mercy?
In many cases, it's a matter of legacy. During the final days in office, outgoing presidents may try to rush through pet projects and grant pardons to burnish their image.
There have been controversies in the past when presidents bypass the process to give last-minute pardons to friends or donors.
2 hours before Bill Clinton left office, he pardoned financier Mark Rich, whose wife had been a big donor to the Clinton Presidential Library.
Well, Mark Rich was a Clinton confidant who was on the FBI's 10 most wanted list because he had a habit of trading with regimes that were under U.S. sanctions. And so he was facing life in prison for racketeering, tax evasion, and trading with the enemy.
Some thought Rich had bought his pardon with a donation.
Money, money, money. Must be funny.
So there you go, presidential pardons extravaganza.
If you have any questions, send them our way. Go to civics101podcast.org.
Everybody in the audience, now listen to me carefully, is being given
a full pardon.
From PRX.